here is a real snail, and it's designed to cut through paper easily. Well, let's cut to the chase, because SJ Dimmock make the moulds. How do you do it?
Well, firstly, the customer come to us with their requirement. Unfortunately, their supplier could not supply them anymore, so they gave me the mouldings that they wanted the mould made for, so I reverse engineered by copying the plastic components and created a mould from them.
So you've been using the Joe Mars machines. Tell me the process, how does it work?
Well, firstly, we buy a die setting, then we integrate the plastic components into a mould using our CAD system. Then we use various machining processes to nibble out as much of the remaining material as possible. Then we make an electrode from solid copper on our VMC machines. Then we mount them to the Joe Mars machines and we spark erode in. That gives us what you can see here, really nice sparked finish. Very, very accurate too.
Yeah, the finish looks exactly like the finish you would expect on a product. How do you get all that fine detailing in there as well with like numbers?
Well, we specifically make all the individual lettering electrodes and then we datum them up and spark erode them in using the Joe Mars machines.
I can see here the finished product, but how does the injection mould process happen?
Well, firstly, I mean, this particular one is in the middle of assembly stages at the moment. This is what we call the fixed half, which means this is where the plastic enters into the mould. So this hole here will actually have what we call a sprue bush. The plastic injection moulding machine will inject under high pressure the plastic in through this nozzle here. It'll filter down through a runner system, which is on the other side. It'll come in via these gate systems here, straight into the mould. After a period of cooling, the mould will then open and then eject off on the machine.
Wow, it really is amazing when you see the finished product, but the work that goes into it prior. And how do you find your Joe Mars machines for doing this process?
I'd be lost without them, to be honest. I couldn't do the job without them.
Well, there you have it, some cutting-edge technology from SJ Dimmock.